Good evening, folks, and welcome to the special edition of An Hour with Bob. Here, by the way, this is my first show, New Year's 2017, and it comes with a difficult problem. I'm just recovering from pneumonia. I've been laid up for the last couple weeks. I'm still not right, so if you see me sniffing a lot and blowing my nose, I'm sorry for it, but that's the way it is. I wanted to do a show because I promised these youngsters a show. So we're doing a show tonight. We got my good friend Jason Morel's with us tonight, magician extraordinaire. He's with us tonight. And we even have, we got to have a nutritionist on this show, the first of the year, the beginning of the year. Right? You with us? Well, we'll get to her in a minute. But first, I got to say hi to Carolyn.
Yes.
How you doing?
1, 2, 3. Hi, Bob.
It didn't work. They didn't do it. They didn't do it.
How about you?
Hi.
Hi. Now your name is?
Ava.
Ava what?
Bajakian.
And you are how old?
6.
6, but going to be 7 in a week, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you are? Jason?
Jason.
Jason. Jason? And you are?
Carolyn Sweet Smiley.
Now, Carolyn, we know each other.
Yes, we've talked a few times. Yes. Yes, we have.
Are you with the Don Rodrigues
Karate
School?
I'm with Don Rodrigues Karate Academy in Warwick. And Jason is in my Tiny Tots class. And Ava used to be a Tiny Tot.
But she's not tiny anymore. She's a big girl.
She's in the big girls class. Yeah. Yes. She's in the 4 o'clock Tuesday, Thursday class, right?
Mm-hmm.
4 o'clock Tuesday, yes. Thursday class. And, yes. And when does he have classes?
He has classes on Monday and Wednesday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And he's been in school how long?
He's been in our program, in our Tiny Tots program, for just about a year. He started when he was 3. Our program for Tiny Tots is 3 through 5 years old.
That's unbelievable.
Yes,
and,
it is.
And the reason why I asked you to come here tonight is because I saw these kids perform
at our Toys for Tots tournament earlier this year.
Last year, December.
Yes.
I'm absolutely amazed at how well these kids do, even a young one like this
yes.
guy.
Yes.
And he's a veteran almost. He's been there almost.
Almost,
a year.
Yes. And each of them would like to do a little form for you.
Really?
For our audience, yes.
Okay.
All right, we're going
to... Now, tell me about the belts first.
Ava's wearing what we call an advanced white belt. Now, this is a halfway belt between white, which is our beginning belt,
right,
and yellow, which is our next rank above that. And so she is in between. She's studying for her yellow belt.
Okay.
And she has 2 stripes, which means she's going to be testing for it soon.
Wow.
Jason has a yellow stripe belt in our Tiny Tot system, and he's going to be testing soon for his Tiny Tot blue stripe belt.
Cool.
So we're going to be practicing for that shortly. And I am a 3rd degree black belt.
Yeah, you are a black belt.
I am a 3rd degree. And wow. Very proud of that. Worked very hard.
Well, you should be.
And that's what these children aspire to do.
And you've been doing karate how long?
For almost 18 years.
Wow.
Yes.
And again, you're originally from Rhode Island?
I'm originally from Barrington? Rhode Island. I am from Rhode Island, but I was born in Fall River, Massachusetts. And I grew up in Barrington, and I've lived in Newport and Providence currently.
Okay.
And for the last 20 years or so. But I'm just a New England gal. I like all of New England.
Yeah. But you've been with the Don Rodrigues Karate Academy for?
For 18 years, just about. Yes, wow. I work in the office twice a week. I teach Tuesday, Thursday, 6 o'clock kids class, which is our 6 through 12-year-old class, which is, she is in another class just like that. My friend, Mrs. Therian, teaches that class. And then I teach Tiny Tots 3 days a week, and then I also assist in our Tuesday, Thursday, 11 a.m. adult class.
Wow.
So I'm all over.
You are.
And
you
I help out at tournaments. I've been a competitor during the early to late 2000 to 2010 period. And I do whatever my bosses tell me to do with a smile most of the time.
All right. Well, what are you going to do for us?
Okay. I think we're going to have Jason do a number 1 blocking form. So he's going to stand right over there.
Let me see.
Right over there, Jason, right here. And are you going to do that all by yourself? Okay,
wow.
Let's do
let
it
me
then,
see.
Huh?
Let me see.
All right. Jason, front position. Bow. Kubodachi stance move. Ayah, big ki-ai. Ayah. Go ahead. Number one blocking form. Ayah. Go ahead. Okay, upward block. Yeah. Another one. Yeah. Downward block. Yeah. Another one. Yeah. Elbows. Yeah. And bow. All right, awesome.
Wow.
Now
how hard is it to teach a young kid that?
Well, it's a little
you're
bit
have
difficult.
Obviously,
in spades. In spades. And I hope that my 10-year Don Rodrigues has taught me as much patience as I need to know in order to work with all of our children effectively. But the younger the child, the more patience, and sometimes the more challenging the teaching well. Ava wants to do number two blocking form for you.
Okay.
Ava, would you like to go up there and do it all by yourself? All right, Ava, front position. Bow. Kubodachi stance move. And you may step forward and do your blocking form.
Hits.
Big key eyes. And bow.
Wow, right. Very good.
Job. Now, the children would like to do a form together for you.
Oh, good.
Okay, we're going to do our number one knife hand blocking form, okay? All right, so you two stand up there, turn, face the camera. No, this way. Front position. Bow, Kubodachi stance, move. And number one block. Big ki-ai. Number one block. Number two. Number three. Number four. Number five. Number six. Number seven. Bend your knees. Number seven. Number eight. Elbows. And bow. Okay, good job.
Good job.
Good job. All right.
And neither one of these kids have been here over a year.
Well, Ava's been here
just about a year.
And Jason's been here just about a year. So almost about the same amount of
time. Right.
And this is their first experience in front of a camera.
And that's
so
amazing. That's something in itself.
Yes, absolutely.
And they're handling it well.
Yes, very much so. Now, what we'd like to do is we'd like to show you some punches and kicks. Can we do that?
Go for it.
All right. I'm going to give this to you so you can
keep
it for me.
Punches and kicks, huh?
All right, we're going to do some punches. Are you ready? Mm-hmm. Let's do a single two-knuckle punch.
Yeah. Ooh.
Move. How about the hammer? Move.
Yeah.
Move.
Yeah.
How about a vertical punch? Move.
Yeah.
Move.
Yeah.
All right, how about a back punch? Move.
Yeah.
Move.
Yeah.
How about a back fist? Move. Move.
Yeah.
How about a hammer? Move.
A hammer?
Move.
Huh?
All right, good
Wow,
job.
That's pretty cool.
And now
you're all wound up now. Look, he's ready to go now.
And now we're going to show you some kicks, sir.
Okay.
All right, are you ready? Would you do a
Oh, he's already. Look at
Jason.
Look at this. Oh, wow.
Ready, move.
Hey.
How about the other side? Move.
Yeah.
Good. Ava, move.
Hey.
Move.
Hey.
Good. How about an instep kick? Move.
Yeah.
Move.
Yeah.
Move.
Hey.
Move. Okay, very good. How about one more kick? How about a side kick? Turn to the side. Move.
Wow.
Side. The other side.
Wow.
Okay, now Ava's going to do a little bit fancier of a kick. It's called a roundhouse kick.
Roundhouse. Oh, I know what those are.
Good. Move. Excellent. Good job.
Nice job.
And
Jason's really ready to go now, huh?
Yes, he's warmed up.
He loosened right up.
Jason, would you like to show some blocks?
Yeah.
You ready? Upward block. Come on, block it. Good. Downward block. Good. And inward block. Good. Inward block. Outward block. Good. Move. Excellent. All right, Ava, it's your turn. Upward block. Good. And downward block. Good. Inward block. Ah, good. Really block. Okay, and outward block. Move. Good. Excellent. Good job.
Wow, nice job.
And
good job.
Right.
Hey, Jason, come here. You're warmed up now, huh? You're all, come here, talk to me. You like karate?
Yeah?
What's your last name now? You gotta tell me?
Yeah.
What is it?
I forget.
You forgot it?
Rafe.
What? Oh, you're dancing now. Is that dancing?
Jason, at the tender age of 4, is a WWE aficionado.
Really?
Yes, he goes to meets, and he goes to shows, and he sees them on TV. And
wow.
He just loves to do some of their moves.
Yeah? What's your favorite move? Come here, turn around this way, turn that way. What's your favorite move?
I don't know.
Who's your favorite fighter? Who's your favorite wrestler?
Sammy.
Sammy?
Sammy Zayn.
Who is it?
Sammy Zayn.
Zane.
Oh. Now, what does he look like?
Big. Really big?
No.
He's got red hair?
Yeah.
He's got red hair. You got blonde hair.
Yes.
Right? And what do you like to do?
I like to do kicks.
You like to do kicks?
Yes.
What do you do when you're not doing karate? What else do you do? Are you good in school?
Yeah.
Yeah? What grade?
First.
First grade? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good for you. And where were you in school? You're not in school yet, right?
Mm-hmm. He's in preschool.
Oh, he is?
Yes.
Excuse me,
very
huh?
Important.
That's very impressed. You guys are great. You enjoy karate?
Yeah.
And you go, what, 2 times a week?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? And you do, too. You go 2 times a week?
Uh-huh.
Yeah?
Yes.
Wow, they're sharp.
Oh, I think they like sparring a lot, but unfortunately, we only have one headgear.
Right.
But... They can show you on the pad a little bit what they do in sparring. Would
okay.
you like to see that?
Sure.
Okay. All right, Ava. You're first. Are you ready? Can you see? All right, Ava. Kick and punch. There you go.
All right.
You want to try something on the other side? Go ahead.
Come on, get into it now. Get into it, Ava.
All right. And a big hammer.
Oh, that would hurt.
You, Jason, go ahead.
Ooh.
Good job. Oh. All right, keep going, bud.
Oh.
And a big hammer.
Wow, you are a tough guy, huh?
Right.
And a good dancer, too.
I do not teach dance.
You don't teach dance?
No.
He does a good job.
Yes.
Wow, you guys are great.
And we appreciate you having us on. It's a really nice experience.
Yes,
really,
and they did well. They did very well.
Yes.
And it's unusual to see a child so young.
Yes, well, not only that, but we encourage the children to practice their material. And sometimes that's a little bit of a challenge with schedules and other activities and mom and dad working and so forth. But we encourage them to practice so that they can advance to their next stripe level or the next belt level.
Right.
And we have classes available for extra help. And we also encourage them to enjoy what they're doing, because if you don't enjoy what you're doing, then you're not going to practice, and therefore you're not going to advance in your karate experience. So
and
we
it's my experience
that
kids that take karate do better in school than kids that don't.
They do. Karate is well known for helping kids to concentrate, to focus. We encourage such values as honesty, integrity. We encourage kids to not use karate on other people,
right.
To use it only when the last resorts of defense fail them. And we also encourage them to use karate as a means of discipline.
I was waiting for that word to come out.
Discipline. And that does show up in their schoolwork and their overall performance. And Dara Rodrigues, as you know, is a world-class promoter of tournaments. He's a 10th degree grandmaster, you know that.
Right.
Sean Chris is a 9th degree. And they run a very efficient school, very well rounded school, and they're very highly recommended when students come into our school for the first time.
All right. Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
I know I'll shake your hand, but I don't want to give you my cold.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And this is our bow. We're going to bow to you.
You got to bow?
Ready, guys?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And there's
thank
something
you.
In the box there for both of you and for your cousin, okay? Go get it over there in the box. Come on, folks. Let's get over here. We got to talk to my other guest. Oh, gosh. Wasn't that great? Come on. Give me a hand, folks. They were great. Well, we're back here, folks. Oh, gosh. Oh, who have I got here? Dara
LoBuono.
LoBuono. And you got to talk because I have to help. How you doing?
Well, good. How are you? Thanks for having me.
Good. Now, you're a nutritionist going for your doctorate's degree?
Yes, I'm a
down at URI.
Yep.
So you have where'd you go to undergrad school?
I did my undergrad in nutrition at NYU and then my master's and dietetics internship at the University of Rhode Island as well. I was here about 2 or 3 years ago for grad school, worked in New Jersey for 2 years, and now I'm back, so.
Wow.
Yep.
Well, first of all, let's talk about the event you got coming up. What's this about? Explain that to us.
So we have a couple events coming up. I'm here with the Rhode Island Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, and March is actually National Nutrition Month. So it's a whole campaign to promote healthy choices and a healthy diet. The theme this month is putting your best fork forward.
Okay.
So all about making healthy choices and not only thinking about picking healthier food choices, but also the amount that we have.
Well, that's a big thing with Americans, right? We eat too much food.
Yeah, our portions are huge, exactly.
Now, is it true that the color of the plate makes a difference?
Yes, the color.
As well as the size of the plate.
Yes. So if you can trick yourself into eating less if you're plate is smaller.
Right.
And then certain colors stimulate appetite, like red and yellow.
Red and yellow stimulate appetite?
Yes.
What lessens your appetite? Purple or what?
I don't remember. I'd have to go back to my
Well, I got to know that because I got to lose weight. My big problem is, you know, I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't gamble, I don't do prescription medication, but I love ice cream.
That's okay. We never say you have to cut out any food, so you can always have some ice cream.
No, but I eat ice cream like every day. I do. I can eat ice cream for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Maybe you try having it every other day.
You think? But what I do is I refuse to make a bowl of ice cream.
It's so what do you do then? A cup.
Always a cup.
Okay. So you portion it out.
Yeah, but sometimes I have 2 cups.
That's the problem.
No, I know. I try to keep it down to what.
What's your favorite flavor?
Cup. Almost anything except chocolate.
Chocolate, okay.
I don't like anything with chocolate base.
Okay. Vanilla's my favorite.
Vanilla's my favorite. and then it goes with maple walnut, probably.
Okay.
Right up there.
But for the month of March, so we're going to probably have an event towards the end of the month.
Okay.
Part of our organization, we do one or two free community events for the public a year. So last year we did... looking at the different benefits of plants and the medicinal purposes. So we took people to the URI gardens and they learned about...
Which my niece has a lot to do with. You know.
Oh, very cool. Maybe she was there.
Kate Venturini.
Cool. I'll have to look her up.
She's a horticulturalist down there.
Oh, very cool. Yeah, they have a great department there. And I think in the past we've also done mindful eating activities. So. Which is a strategy of helping people make better choices and kind of making eating more of a process than just kind of eating on the run, which in addition to large portions, Americans, we kind of tend to eat on the run. So in the car or while we're working at the desk.
And also, I eat, I don't eat normal times. I eat breakfast.
That's
in the
important.
Morning.
Good.
Now, is it bad or good to eat a banana with breakfast?
Oh, so that's a myth. I don't think there's anything wrong with having a banana in the morning.
I have bananas and strawberries in my cereal.
I think that's fine. I just, you know, it's really, if you had 3 bananas a day, that might be too much. But in the morning, that's totally fine.
Because it's not bad to have a banana, one banana a day.
No, there's nothing wrong with bananas.
Sometimes blueberries, too, by the way, if they're in season.
Those are great. They actually have been...
Antioxidants?
They might promote memory, just like even a serving a day. There's some research out on that, yeah. But we always like to say the best fruit is the fruit you'd eat. So I'd rather you have a banana than not have fruit at all. So it might have a little bit more sugar compared to others, but...
I don't eat processed sugar.
Yeah, exactly.
I drink iced coffee constantly, but I don't have any sugar in it.
Good.
And no sweetener either.
Yeah.
Is that good?
Depends on how much coffee you're having, but that's good that you're not having it with any sugar or
Well, how much coffee is no good for you?
That's a great question that's always up for debate. The dietary guidelines put out that you can have up to, I think it, they said 8 cups a day.
Oh, I don't drink that much.
I would say probably like 2 or 3 is fine.
Oh, I drink more than 2 or 3. I probably drink 5 or 6 cups a day. No, I drink iced coffee.
Okay, it's a little watered down.
Yeah.
But the
With a little milk.
Not cream.
I know, 8 cups is only 8 ounces.
Yeah.
I drink these big.
The big ones, yeah.
Not a big gulp, but a large iced coffee.
The super-sized ones, yeah. And then we also have an April coming up every year. It's actually our 14th annual
5K run?
Yep, Nutrition Fuels Fitness 5K
that,
and Health.
That is what, April what?
April 9th.
Where is that?
It's at Goddard Park in Warwick, yeah. So this is going to be our 14th one, and what's special about it this year is we're teaming up with the American Heart Association. So we're also joining in with the Go Red campaign for women as part of the promotion. So we expect to have a really big turnout this year in April. And actually starting now through the month of February, if you sign up on our website, eatrightri.org, you can eatrightri.org, you can get $5 off if the registration fee
To run the 5K.
Yep, to run the 5K. If you put in the promo code Go Red.
Okay.
So through the month of February, we're doing a $5.
So say it again. If you sign up
From now through February,
right.
Just type in the promo code Go Red.
No, wait. To sign up to where's the website?
The website. Again? It's eatrightri.org.
Eatrightri.org.
Yeah, I have a flyer here too.
Okay.
It's on the website on the bottom of the flyer.
Okay, so if they sign up, so they go to the website, and
yep.
they sign up,
yep.
they got to punch in that special
code. Go Red.
Go Red.
And they can get $5 off.
Okay.
And we're not just having the 5K, it's also, there's a family fun run. It's a 1K. I'll probably be running the 1K because I'm not really over 3 miles. Yeah.
The 5K is what? It is about 3 miles, right?
Yeah.
A little over 3 miles.
Yep. So 1K would be just less than a mile. So. If you're just getting back into running, or if you never really run before, the 1K is definitely.
Can you walk?
You can walk,
can
run
you
it.
Hopscotch or something.
Yep, as long as you get through the finish line, we don't care. And we also are having a health.
Now, is it in Goddard
yep.
Park, right in Goddard Park?
Right by the carousel.
Okay.
Yeah. So the whole theme is red. We're going to be giving out red T-shirts. We're going to have the health expo as well, so there'll be face paint, massage therapist, physical therapist. I think Care New England's doing blood pressure screening as well, so a lot of different activities to promote local businesses as well as raise money for the Rhode Island Healthy Schools Coalition and the American Heart Association.
Right. Hence the red?
Yep. Exactly.
The heart, the red, the heart,
yeah.
Is that right?
Yep. And in addition to raising money for them, it also goes towards our scholarship fund. So every year we give money to one URI student and one Johnson & Wales student.
Yep.
Again, we hold community events that the money goes towards, as well as just different community events that we have and awards that we give out to people,
right.
As well as a part of our association, we want dietitians to get out into the community. So
now, what is the Dietetics Association, what is that?
So the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics is a national organization.
Right. What do you got to be a member?
So you could be a student or a nutrition, someone in the nutrition field, but it's mainly the biggest professional organization for registered dietitians and diet technicians.
Right.
So it's the whole purpose is to improve the health and nutrition of people in America. And
the definition of a registered dietitian is what?
So it's a long-winded definition, but basically, a dietitian can call themselves a nutritionist, but a nutritionist can't call themselves a dietitian.
A dietitian can call themselves a nutritionist, but a nutritionist can't call themselves a dietitian.
Right. So we have to sit, basically we do 4 years of a bachelor's degree, and then we're required to do an internship, which is in different hospitals throughout.
Oh, right, right.
So more of like a clinical practice. And at the end of that, we sit for a national boards exam, and then we're a registered dietitian.
Wow.
But then starting in 2024, we're all going to be required to have master's degrees as well to practice. So
oh,
it's a lot of education, for sure.
Wow. So you can be a dietitian and a nutritionist.
Yes.
But you can't be a nutritionist.
And call yourself a dietitian. All right. That would be like if I called myself a nurse, but I never took the license to be a nurse.
Okay.
Kind of thing. Or an MD, and I'm not.
Right. Well, you're going for your doctorate degree, right?
Yes.
So you will be a doctor, but not a doctor.
Not,
not
yeah.
An MD, right?
I can't save someone's life.
No. Well, you can if you teach them to eat right.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Preventative.
So what are you going to do when you graduate? What do you expect to do?
I hopefully will teach and do research in a college.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Or maybe I'll co-host with you. I don't know.
There you go. So how long you got left? How long before you?
I just started, so probably 3 or 4 more years.
Really?
Yeah.
And how long you been going to school now?
I just started back in September. So I worked for 2 years in a fitness and wellness center, and then started my first year of school in September.
Wow.
So I have some time.
Yeah. Wow. Well, that's it's a long time.
Yeah.
I
yeah.
I didn't know there was that much involved in it.
Yeah. A lot of people think it's only a couple of years, but it's a long process. So you have to conduct a study, defend your project, and then after that, graduate. So.
I know everybody. I know a couple dietitians, or should I say nutritionists? What should I say? What's better?
I go by either. It's registered dietitian, nutritionist. So.
All right. What is some healthy food tips?
Tips. Okay. I think it's always being realistic. So.
What do you mean realistic?
Well, what kind of tips are you looking for? Like, just a general...
What kind of food you eat, how much food you should eat, what food you should stay away from.
Okay, yeah.
Like
well, we never tell you you can't eat something. I think that's the main thing.
Yep.
So try and incorporate everything in moderation is one of our main philosophies. Not skipping meals, because then you're just going to...
Well, that's what I do a lot.
Yeah.
I skip lunch a lot.
Right, and then you get really hungry later, and you might eat more than you should.
What about eating late?
Eating late, it's somewhat of a myth if you're healthy. It really is about calories. At the end of, I don't want to say all calories are created equal because they're not, but if you need 2,000 calories a day to maintain your weight,
right.
And you have dinner at 9 p.m., and you've only had 1,500 calories at that point, and you have 500 at dinner, you're not going to gain weight because you're...
There's no thing about going to bed after you eat?
I personally wouldn't sleep as well. If you have acid reflux and you're not supposed to eat close to bedtime or certain conditions where you shouldn't eat right before bed, then you shouldn't.
Right before bed, but no, I might eat like 11 o'clock at night.
And then go to...
1.
Right, right. But yeah, it's really... If you're having excess calories, it's more about that than the time that you eat.
Well, the ice cream, that's excess calories.
Right. Then that's where the myth comes in. So you're eating additional calories.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that is my problem.
But, again, like we were talking about, being realistic. So if you wouldn't be happy if you could never have ice cream again. So
oh,
it's
I'd
not
be unhappy.
Not having it every day, but maybe having it less
frequently.
Well,
you know, it's weird. I mean, I quit smoking, like just saying I'm quitting. I'm not smoking ever again. And
right.
I quit smoking, but I cannot quit ice cream. I just love ice cream.
Well, it's funny because my advisor and I will talk about a lot. you can't just cut out food. You need food to live.
That's right, yeah.
So you don't need cigarettes to live, right? You might...
Well, cigarettes to help you die.
Right, exactly.
They won't help you live.
But so if you need to eat food and you know what the food you like tastes like, that you like, taste what it tastes like, it's kind of hard to forget about it. And there's so many choices. So you can't just not eat to get rid of food.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Does that make sense?
Kinda. So I should, how many calories should I, you're saying 2,000?
No.
How many calories should I have in the course of a day?
I can't just tell you that off the top of my head. It would be based on height, weight, age, your activity level, your goals. So if you want to maintain your weight, if you want to gain weight, if you want to lose weight.
I want to lose weight.
It would be based on all of that. And we have a special calculation that we estimate your energy needs with.
Well, the thing that affects me.
We could do it after the show.
Knee, because I've had 3 knee replacements.
Right.
Ever since I've had the hospitalized with knee replacements, I've gained weight that I never had before.
Because you can't do
as
much.
I'm always there, very active.
Right.
Always moving around, always doing something.
Right.
And I can't do as much. So, hence, I'm the heaviest I've ever been.
So, you want to focus definitely on more nutrient dense foods that don't have as much calories. So, like that. Anything that's, you know, fresh, less processed, like you said, you don't have a lot of processed sugar, fruits and vegetables. No one ever gained weight from eating, you know, too many vegetables or fruit, you know, so.
Yeah. I'm not a big vegetable fan, but ironically, I love spinach.
That's great. Yeah, you can have it.
I like spinach.
Yeah, in multiple ways then. Some people even throw it in a smoothie.
So spinach in a smoothie?
You can't taste it. It'll make it a pretty color green like that.
Oh, no, I don't like green looking food. Great.
We'll have to stick with blueberries then.
Blueberries I like. Blueberries I really like. Well, you know, we got Jason.
Yes, sir.
I got, you know, you met Jason, right?
Yeah, I met him earlier.
Jason Morel. Who's with you here?
The lovely Miss Billy Lynn.
Okay. How you doing?
I'm well, and you?
God bless you for being here with Jason. Now, Jason's been here a number of times. Been here a lot, Jason. Huh?
Thank you, Bob.
I see you got 2 decks of cards over there. One's a big set and one's a small deck. What is that all about?
Yes, for the vision impaired.
There you go. That's for me. Although, actually, that's why I don't have bad vision. I have pretty good vision. In fact, I went to an eye doctor recently, and he said I don't need any. I thought I might need glasses by now, and he said no.
Well, I'm sure you'll love this effect, then, Bob.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Jason Morel is a magician extraordinaire. He's from Rhode Island, right?
That's correct.
From right?
Yes.
Well, you looked at me funny when I said you were from Rhode Island. You're from Rhode Island.
Born and raised in Coventry.
There you go. There you go. So what are you going to do for us tonight?
Well, Bob, if I can ask you kindly, please, I'd like to help you bring your chair over here because I want you to sit right here.
You need
here.
Me here?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know I was going to be part of this thing.
You're the star.
Oh, you didn't have me plug in either.
Oh, I forgot.
All right.
You got to bring your chair over here.
Oh, my chair. Oh.
I'm going to help you lift it.
All right, you take the chair over there while I do this.
I don't want you to work too hard, Bob.
And I'll be back with you in a minute.
Okay.
So think of something else for me to ask you.
Okay.
Now,
see,
Bob.
Can you help me lose weight?
Bob, I'm a magician, not a miracle worker.
He's a comedian, too. All right, what do you want? You want me to sit down?
Yes, please.
Sit down? Okay.
Now, Bob, this all illusion, right. It's called
gonna double. Make my gut disappear. Go ahead. This illusion is what?
It's called double vision.
Double vision, okay.
And there's a reason why.
Okay.
It takes 2 decks of cards.
2 decks of cards. Never okay. Put your back to a
camera. Thank you. The first deck.
Yep.
I'm going to show that all the cards are different.
Wow. You got that?
Yeah,
Jason, you probably turned it the wrong way. Go ahead. You got a joker on the front, okay. What else you got? I see the jack, king, ace, three, 7, 10, 4, 5, 10, 8.
If they're all different. Okay?
You're playing with a full deck then.
That's correct. Now, there is one card missing out of this deck.
There is?
Yes.
I already know what it is.
You do?
Yeah.
Well, we'll see.
All right.
It's going to be the card that you pick.
Now, I have another deck
here.
Go
ahead.
What I want you to do...
Come over this way.
Yes.
What do you want me to do?
I'm going to riffle the cards.
Riffle the cards?
Yes.
I never heard that term before. Riffle the cards.
Yes. The camera's going to get a closer view of the cards.
Okay.
And I'm going to do the same thing. What okay. I want you to do
yeah.
is tell me when to stop.
Okay.
When you say stop,
right.
you're going to choose the card. You're going to
okay.
pick the card.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. You okay. ready?
You're going to get a closer view of the cards.
All right. Close-up view. Zoom right in. All right. Are you
you're going to say stop.
Okay. I just want to see what you're doing. Stop!
Okay, take the card.
Okay.
That one right there, you said
no,
stop.
No, I want this one.
You said stop.
Oh, I can't have that one?
No, you said stop right there. Okay. Don't show it to me.
Okay.
Show it to the camera.
Don't look.
I'm
turn
not.
Around.
Now, Bob, I have no idea what card you chose, but there's one card.
One card.
Selected out of this deck that I already pre-selected. That's in this envelope.
Yeah.
And one card that you're holding on to. That I think you picked. And if I may ask card, Mr. Bob.
What card is it?
What card did you choose?
The Nine of Diamonds.
The Nine of Diamonds?
Yeah.
May I?
The Queen of Diamonds. Wow, very good. I tried to trick you, couldn't trick you either. Very good. Wow, that's impressive.
Thank you.
That's impressive. Wow.
That's why we call it double vision.
Double vision. Nice job. Jason Morel. Wow. Very good, kid. Very good.
Thank you.
And it's trusty assistant, huh?
Absolutely.
Very much so.
Well, let's get back over here. Let me talk to my nutritionist. Besides that, oh, Jason, my chair, please. You know what I forgot to show you? Met this woman in Thailand. She was a manufacturer in China. And I had her send me a couple of the things they manufacture from China. This company manufactured. They just got the UL listing. You got this shot here? Just got a UL listing. Look at this light. Is this light unbelievable?
It's bright.
Huh? Is that bright? I don't want to put it in your face. This is a 15 watt light. Look at this. How's that, John? Huh? You got that? Huh? Too much or what?
Yeah, too much.
Too much light. 15 watt, and it is also dimmable. And what is really cool about this light is this connection. It connects with a Romex. This box connects with a Romex connector, and it's aluminum, so it's very lightweight. In fact, I have another one here. It's very lightweight. This box goes up. You want a rough wire a house. You put this box up above the ceiling. Romex connector goes in here, ties into these wires with the ground. You put it up in the ceiling. This thing weighs no more than a couple of ounces.
Wow.
You can rewire or pre-wire the house. And then when you're ready to go, now here's a smaller one. This is a 9 watt, I think.
Wow.
Huh? Isn't that unbelievable?
Where can I order that?
And they're dimmable. And I'm trying to find a place where I can, somebody's interested in them, and I can buy a whole container of them.
And sell it.
Quite quite a bargain. And what's really nice about them, what happened? I got no wires here, John? Here you go. I'm not wired, John. All this time, I haven't been wired. Oh, we're back to the batteries, huh? Your famous batteries? Hey, John, look at this. Look at this light. Is this light amazing or what?
I love it.
This light, you can hang at a suspended ceiling or in sheetrock or in imperial board above a ceiling. You don't need, unlike the old-fashioned lights where you had to have the canister up there and you had to have that much space up above the ceiling, you can put this almost flush. You can put this flush with a ceiling, with a sheetrock ceiling, right against the studs.
Take eight of them, huh?
I'd love to do my whole house with them. They're great.
Next thing.
They're very inexpensive, too. And they're dimmable. That's what's amazing. LEDs that are dimmable.
I should put it on a dimmer.
You should try it on a dimmer. All right, we're back. What do you think of that?
I might have to order some.
If I could get enough of an order, I'd buy a whole, I really would. I'd buy a whole container. If I found a lighting center that wanted to go in with me, I'd buy a whole container, have them shipped over here, because they just now got approved. They got UL listed and approved, so that you can use them in the United States.
Oh, wow.
They're great lights. And if you ever had a problem, you broke one or something, all you got to do is disconnect. It's a quick disconnect. This thing goes in, doesn't even screw in, it just turns.
Wow.
It locks in. It's locked in, see? And you turn it a quarter turn, and it comes apart. They're cool, very cool lights.
User-friendly.
Yes. There's a person I met when I was in Thailand. I met her in a restaurant in Thailand, and she's Chinese, and she works for a Chinese company. And she told me what she did, and I said, well, send me some of the lights. And she did. She sent me four of them. They got this, that's a 15, a 13, 11, and a 9 volt.
You're
not
all
volt, watt. Watt light.
You're
watts.
All set.
Only 9 watts. I mean, that's unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean, a little 60-watt bulb, four of these is less than a 60-watt bulb.
I'm not an expert in lights, but how was the food in Thailand?
Excellent. It really is, you know. Food is very good. It's spicy, but it's very good.
That's good.
And unlike us, like I said before, the portions in Europe and in Asia are much smaller than the portions. Americans eat way too much food, myself included, by the way.
Did you feel hungry then when you were there?
No, well, I shouldn't say myself included because I don't eat. I'm not a big eater anymore. I used to eat a lot, but I don't eat a lot. But I eat it at all the wrong times, right?
Right. I don't know. I don't know. You tell me.
I like mashed potatoes now. That's bad for you, right?
You can make them healthy.
Yeah, but it's not healthy. I put butter on them, is it? I like butter.
Butter in moderation, like I said. But
what's better, butter or margarine?
Everyone asks that. I would probably say butter.
Yes.
That's my personal
opinion.
Yeah,
me too, because it's real.
Yeah, exactly.
Margarine is an oil.
It's man-made, yeah. So yeah. A small amount of butter or some of the plant stanols that they're made to have heart health benefits. There's certain butters that are like stanols, so they're thought to lower cholesterol.
What are they called?
Stanols.
Never heard of it.
Plant stanols. So they're like phytochemicals that are thought to have good properties that lower your cholesterol. But again, everything in small amounts. A fat that's liquid at room temperature is better for you than a fat that's solid at room temperature. Does that make sense? So like olive oil is liquid at room temperature.
Is better for you than?
Because it's unsaturated.
Wait a minute, it's better for you at room temperature?
So like a fat that would be solid at room temperature, like butter or any kind of like high fat red meat, those are saturated fats.
Right.
High in saturated fats, where like oils and nuts are higher in unsaturated fats, or avocado.
Right.
So those are the fats that are good for you and are thought to help with heart health.
Oh.
Does that make sense?
Not really, but it's all right. It's all good.
So
it's
not all fats are created equal.
Yep.
That's what they say, or what we say.
What you say.
Yep.
I had a question. I just forgot what it was now. Oh. Everybody, first of the year, they make their
New Year's resolution,
which I did not make this year. People make them. They all join the gyms, and they all
they're
say
geared
they're
up.
Gonna
yep.
do this and do that and do
right.
this. And by February, it's forget about it.
Right, usually right after Valentine's Day, the gym's kind of quiet.
Well, because the woman gets chocolates on Valentine's Day, right?
So then it's game over, right?
Yeah, right. So why is that? Why is that? Why is it that people just give up after a month?
I think it's a lot of different reasons. Again, our society, whether it's large portion sizes or eating on the run, we also kind of want things instantly. So a lot of people won't see results quickly, and then they get discouraged. So it might be the types of goals they're setting.
Right.
Maybe they're...
The goals are too big or too...
Yeah, so maybe they're setting unrealistic goals, or someone who sets kind of smaller goals. We call them SMART goals, so they're very specific, they're measurable, they're attainable.
Right.
They're realistic and they're timely. That's
yeah, but some of them, sometimes when they set goals like that, it's, you know, come on, it's a joke. I'm going to lose 2 pounds, whoop-de-doo.
I don't think so. I think working with people and they say like 2 pounds in 2 weeks is more attainable than saying I want to lose 10 pounds in 2 weeks.
Right, right.
Or usually we find, like, with people, if we set the goal a little bit easier and then they achieve that goal, it's not going to set them up for failure. Where, like,
right.
So if they tell me I'm going to go to the gym every day this week, like, I'm going to be realistic. I don't think anyone can make it to the gym 7 days. I don't have time to go to the gym 7 days a week.
Well, they call them gym rats. They
yeah.
7 days a week, right?
So maybe we say, you know, you sound really eager about working out. Why don't we just start with 3? And if you do more, that's great.
Right.
So thinking about it that way and focusing more on small things that add up to the bigger picture.
And what tips would you give somebody that wanted to start the first of the year? Well, we're already past the first of the year, but start still in January.
Right.
What they could do to eat healthier.
Okay. Yeah, I definitely think not skipping meals, having a game plan. So I know, like, if I don't have time to, like, buy groceries over the weekend or meal, you know, have lunch ready for the week, it's going to be kind of harder for me to have access to healthy food. So planning ahead is definitely important.
So eating, you don't agree with eating out, right?
I would try to minimize it, just because you can control more what you're putting in your body when you're making it. But again, with time, it's a barrier. You're not going to be able to. It's not realistic to say, oh, I'm going to cook all my meals at home.
Right.
But definitely trying to decrease the amount of times you eat out, or, you know, making modifications when you do dine out. So if you know you're not supposed to have salt, ask them, like, can you make this without salt?
Right. Well, salt is in almost everything, especially canned foods, right?
Yeah.
A lot of salt in canned foods. Because I don't even have a salt shaker in my house.
Yeah. So a lot of times we find that the added salt in people's diet isn't really from the salt shaker, but more from the processed foods.
Right.
Even like low salt pretzels, they're still going to be pretty high in salt.
Well, come on, that's ridiculous. I mean, you would,
or like
you
salt
would think they would know.
Yeah, there's no salt on them, but they still are made with
even
salt.
Even if there's no salt on them, they've still got salt in them.
In them, yes. Because they're making them with salt and baking soda, whatever ingredients are in pretzels.
Really?
Yeah. So that's kind of like some of those things that are surprising to people. But again, not everyone has to worry. I mean, everyone should decrease their salt, but especially if you have high blood pressure or at risk for heart disease. You'd want to.
And why do we have, in this country, why do we have such a high instance of diabetes?
Diabetes? So a lot of it, we call them like modifiable risk factors and then non-modifiable risk factors. So.
Okay, what's the difference between the two?
Modifiable are the ones that you can control, that you can change.
Okay.
And this kind of applies for heart disease too. So it would be diet, activity level, lifestyle, so stress or smoking, where genetics or age might have more, those are things you can't change. So if diabetes runs in your family, you
right.
can't change that. But that's not to say go eat whatever you want and not exercise.
Well, doesn't it have a lot to do with your weight, getting diabetes?
Yeah, so diet and sedentary lifestyle combined increases your weight, which can increase your chance for type 2 diabetes. But it you could still get type 2 diabetes and not be overweight. So there, it isn't only weight.
Wow.
So there is, you know, it could just be from eating poorly, but you might still weigh a normal weight.
So what's better, eating 3 meals a day, which is what we grew up hearing, or eating several meals a day?
I think every dietitian might have a different answer for that. I think it's really
several smaller meals.
Right. I think there's definitely research out there that eating, you know, every 3 to 4 hours is beneficial. But for some people, that's not realistic. As long as they're eating healthy and they prefer the 3 meals, I don't think it's a problem. But again, I think it's kind of like a case by case basis.
Well, I know. I got friends. I can think of one in particular. If he doesn't eat at a certain time, he's like all messed up.
Yeah. Yeah, that's how, like, if I don't eat, like, every 3 or 4 hours, I, like, won't be able to focus.
What is that, low blood sugar? Is that what that is?
Yeah, it could be, like, his blood sugar's too low, so he can't focus, exactly. And that's normal for even non-diabetics, we can get low blood sugar.
Really?
If we go too long without eating.
Yeah, because I don't know, I don't think he's a diabetic, but he...
Right.
He absolutely has to eat at a given time, and he absolutely has to eat something.
Yeah.
After 2 or 3 hours, some kind of... bar or something, but
right.
He has to eat something.
And as long as they're healthy choices, it's fine. And yeah, some people like to eat small amounts throughout the day, and that's totally fine.
Now, you're a member of the
Rhode Island Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, or RYAN.
How do you say it?
RYAN.
RYAN?
Yes.
Okay, now if I wanted to look for a dietitian,
right.
Where would I look for a dietitian?
So you could definitely just go on our website, eatrightri.org, which would be for any dietitian in the state of Rhode Island.
Right, R-I?
Eat Right.
So oh, Eat Right.
Just like we were before, the Eat Right.
Okay.
.org, ri.org, or the national website is just eatright.org. So we have the RI for Rhode Island in there. And you can go on the website and just click on find a dietitian and type in your zip code, and they do give you dietitians in your area. So that could be, you know, if you're interested in speaking with a dietitian, they can help you with individualized meal planning, tips for dining out, healthy eating on a budget. For someone that was diagnosed with diabetes and not really sure how to manage it, they
right.
can help you with the diabetic diet, a heart healthy diet, really whatever, anything that you need that's going to be catered to you. They're not going to give you a generic menu and say, go eat this.
Well, it's all custom to you.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And based on your needs and your calories that you would need.
Now, are dietitians nurses?
No, so registered dietitian.
But I know a dietitian is a nurse.
You could be both. You could be a nurse and a dietitian. Some people might do one first and then go on and do the other one, for sure. But primarily, most people that I know are just dietitians. But yeah, you could do both, for sure. And a lot of the field, the way medicine's going, it's all about interdisciplinary health. So us working with nurses and communicating with physical therapist or speech therapist or...
So specialized.
Yeah, but definitely kind of that holistic approach and looking at the patient or the client beyond just their diet. So like me keeping in mind, you know, you have a bad knee. And if you were working with a physical therapist, like communicating with them about, you know, how many days a week you're doing physical therapy or supposed to be exercising. So definitely looking at it holistically instead of just the diet.
Right, right. Now I'm looking, speaking of bad knee, I'm looking to go to, I'm talking with the people down, I looked on Google what is considered the best orthopedic hospital in the United States. And it's the Hospital of Special Surgeries in New York City.
Oh, yeah.
And I've contacted them, talked to them about trying to find out what the heck is wrong with my knee. Because it's been cut 3 times, it's been replaced 3 times, and it's still not right.
Right. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
My uncle, my aunt had her knee replaced there, and she's doing...
There in New York?
Yeah.
She's
oh,
no
from
kidding.
New York, yeah. So...
Now, they have 2 places, right? They have one in Stamford, Connecticut, and they have one in, I don't know what the address is in New York City, but it's right in New York City. Right?
Yeah, uptown, or maybe in, I'm not sure, it might be in Long Island.
I don't know. I know I wrote the address out on an envelope already because they want a list of they wanted all my MRIs and
everything, yeah.
All kinds of information. Anything I had related to the knee surgeries, yeah.
Wow. But yeah, I've heard good things, so.
But I've heard good things from a lot of people who have had knee replacements in Rhode Island and in Massachusetts, and you know, they're playing tennis two or three weeks later. Not me. Not me.
Know.
I had the first
know.
One replaced, and 2 years later, for 2 years, it was never right, and it ended up collapsing in my house with a 103.9 fever, and I had IFEMI with CRP, the term CRP.
Yeah,
hyperactive
C-reactive protein.
Protein, yeah.
Yeah.
And a normal number for a normal person is under 4. And if it's over, they say, tell me, if it's over 25, it's bad. If it's over 100, it's really, really bad. And mine was 250.
Wow.
Which was extremely bad.
Wow, that's a high inflammation marker there.
And I ended up spending 86 days between the hospital, between the hospital and recovery center.
Wow, was it infected?
Very bad.
Oh my gosh.
In fact, they had to take the knee out and they couldn't put a new knee in.
So you had no knee.
For 66 days, I had no
knee.
Wow.
When was this?
That happened in 2014.
Wow.
And in May 13, 2014, he took my knee out and they didn't put a new knee in until the middle of July. I left the hospital in August of 2014. By 2015, the middle of 2015, I went to another doctor in Massachusetts, and he goes, you know, your knee, your femur is not connected to your knee.
Oh, my goodness.
I go,
goodness.
What are you talking about? He goes, they did a bone scan and an MRI, and he goes, your femur is not connected. I said, how is that even possible? He said, I can't believe you're walking.
Wow.
He said, you must be in excruciating pain when you stand up. I said, oh, yeah, it hurts a lot when I stand up. He said, no, you should be in excruciating pain when you stand up.
Oh, my goodness.
I said, well, it does hurt a lot. We're out of time? Is that what you're trying to tell me? We're out of time. Do you know you're one of the few people that's actually spent a whole hour with
Bob? Oh, my gosh, really? I'm honored.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, this is my 25th year, May 29th is my 25th anniversary.
Oh, congratulations.
On TV. And if I can get help, I hope to put together a real big show for the 25th anniversary. Maybe we'll do a show down at the Warwick Mall or some...
You have to
hot
have a big
location
party.
Where we can
yeah.
have a big party.
Yeah,
right?
I'll be there.
Yeah?
You come to my 5K. And
where's that again? Give it to us.
Goddard Park.
The date.
April 9th.
April 9th, 2017, Goddard Park. Register at 8 a.m. for a 5K or a 1K run.
Right.
Right?
And if you register by the end of February with the promo.
Save $5.
Yep. Promo code is GoRed.
GoRed. But you got to go to what website?
EatRightRI.org.
Okay. Well, thank you for stopping by.
Thank
Dara.
You so much
oh,
for having me.
I didn't shake my hand. I got a cold. I'm sick. I'm sick. Wash your hands now. And folks, thank you for spending an hour with Bob, and I'll see you hopefully when I'm healthier. I'm on my way to Las Vegas. So see you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.